now, they're never approached. And it's true. Like, I was just out at a bar. Black men were there. None of them talked to my friends and I. All pretty girls, black girls, none. And it's like, people say, like, finding someone to have sex with you, to take you out to eat, to compliment you, is not hard. I can go on these apps clearly and find someone that's ready to have sex with me tonight, right now, without even knowing my last name. Literally does not know if I've just got rid of an STD yesterday, but is definitely willing to have sex with me right now. But finding someone that, like, is willing to check on me when I say I'm having a bad day, that's too much. And it's just so frustrating because it's like, I'm just myself. I don't know what else to do.
I see girls ride it all night. Hey, it's back in the park. Yo, man.
Well, I I'm sorry, Bill, but...
Just a minute, Mr. Bailey. I know what you're going to say. I've been doing some thinking while you're out there talking to Daisy, and I guess I was thinking about the same thing you were talking about. Daisy, I'm really not what you think I am. Right now, I'm a big hero because I got on a uniform, and there's a war. Somehow you forgot that there isn't always going to be a war. And after it's all over, why, you'd be married to a cowboy, Daisy, and that's no good.
Bill.
Maybe you don't think that right now. I guess both of us got kind of carried away. I'd never known anyone like you. And the way I figured it, you were kind of lonely when I came along, so... Well, anyway, Mr. Bailey, you see, you don't have to tell me because I know.
But you got it all wrong, Bill. I'd like very much to marry you, if you want me to. Haven't you got anything to say, Sam?
There's not much left for me to say. Goodbye, Daisy.